This one guy named Omar Johnson, and you have this other guy named Lenon Honor that makes videos. And so now you have people saying, why do you keep making these videos of this Omar Johnson guy? Why is he saying he's obsessed with him? And it's kind of funny because they ignored the 20 other people that made the same observation in videos showing that this man has said some things in the past, and they have recorded it on their video that this man, he says one thing, he talks down to some people, but at the same time go back to the same people and want him to support him, and then he wants you to give him money that your hard-earned dollar, and then put a guilt mindset that you shouldn't be spending the money that you should if you're a black person. He come from another black, him being black itself, and you should go to this school which is in the middle of a COVID crisis, and then the school he wants to build, and then the school where the place is located at, people are showing the video that it's not properly set up, it's not properly insulated, it's not properly irrigation system, HVAC system, things like that. And then it's back taxes over on the property. And these people are constantly making this video and showing many people who come to their channel that, hey, this guy been sitting on this project for 11, collecting donations from people from across the country for about left going since 2009, it's until 2000, and they keep on saying in 2013 we're gonna have it up. 2013 run, the school's not open. Then he said it's gonna be 2000, 2016, school never opened up. In 2018, brothers and sisters, school never opened up. And so people were making, and so they said, man, this, and then they come to the conclusion, this guy ain't gonna open up the school. Then someone bring proof and say, well, first of all, he's not paying the utility bills. Then he's not paying the taxes on the building. And so this one particular guy, you go to his channel, Lenon Honor, and there's a few other people. And it's one of those, one that guy named KKC, and there's a couple, a woman named Ansel Edwards to Bengali, and there's another person named Make a Change, there's Nappy Yankee, and there's different individuals that show, go to the site of where this building is located in Delaware, and show you the proof that this is not going to get started off the ground until he pays this amount. And by paying in this amount, that he had to spend, he would need almost $200,000, and then to keep it up, then you need to properly staff and everything else. And then it showed him one point, he was interviewed by different people, and when you start getting kind of personal questions, he gets offensive about it, and trying to claim that he's the first one that did, to have a own, and he pumps himself up. This is the same kind of guy that goes to the cemetery, start talking about ancient African ancestry worship over African black people who was back in the 1600s, 1700s. He go over there and lights incense and do lamentations over like Frederick Douglass and Harriet Tubman's graves. Then he claims that he's related to Marcus Garvey. Then he appoints himself as a prince. And I was like, who nominated to be a prince? And I'm the Prince of Pan African. What is this, the Prince of Pan African? I didn't know there was. I thought when you're a prince from Africa, you actually come from a tribe.
You'd
be like a member of that tribe. If you go to Nigeria, Ghana, you actually become a prince, you know, through the land, through the family, through the chiefs and priests. That's the proper way of being a prince. So how you gonna be a prince or something when you're not even nominated by a certain African or African group? Then that would have to be a collective of people that say, yeah, he's the Prince of Pan Africans. And that would have to, be difficult of Africa.
Yes, man. And people just, they want to hold him up as a leader. Just, I don't really see the point. But you know, some people, so you have people out there saying, you know what, this guy may want to lay off of him, you know, it's getting a little bit too much that he's laying. But the thing about it is that it's I'm sorry, I was just watching the news. Someone stole the dog on 18 by this barbershop. Not his business owner. People are just anyway, getting back to what I'm saying. I'm sorry, I just got distracted. I looked at that like, what the heck? You seen somebody snatching a let me show you. This is what they doing. They broke in, this is in Columbus, Ohio. They just tear up this whole wall. A barbershop, stealing from a barbershop. But anyway, getting back to what I was saying, I'm sorry about that. So what this guy Lenon Honor is doing, and me and him like doing, is showing that this guy is he says something to people, and he's figuring you could just talk it at people, and they're just gonna take in your personality and guilt shame you for doing something that you normally want to do. you know, black people always spend this kind of money on hair products and this, and you should be giving me money for to build up this school for your future black children. It's like he's using these guilt tactics and everything. It's like, and then it was show when it's past years, they called some black people, then when they did contribute, was a certain amount. Then he called them trifling ass Negroes. But people, you know, but he said, I better get, then he turned around and get arrogant and said, I better get some more and more and more. Talking to black people across the country now, this is really, and I mean, they got this, and they got this on the channel saying this. I'm saying it. I mean, they edit out, they play the whole thing, and they put their analogy into it. These people that's getting tired of saying, why you keep showing this, and they pick on this one particular man. He's always making video about this guy. And what he's doing is he's trying to break down, like, you really want this, to have your boys go to this school, baby up under this man. And you have 70 people that still, they willing to look past all that, even have to produce all the evidence that this man, who says that he got 6 degrees, college degrees, and a doctorate in this, and a doctorate that, and a doctorate this, and so when people go ask him, where's your 6 degrees? He gets offensive about that. He gets so offensive. So, you know, and I mean, the guy, this man is, you know, they analyze him, so they making it, and he's been doing this for a long time, for the past 11 years in the community. I thought he was, when he first came out, like most people, I thought he was legit. And so, but when you start really seeing his attitude, man, the way he would have at someone recording at a meeting with people, and the way he talked about people, and it's like, what the heck is wrong with this man? You know, who says stuff like that? And I guess in his own way, he's trying to be, but you know, be sounding less of a professional and sound some dude off the street and just say any old thing. And you know, you have people so-called trying to keep it real, but they don't know how to be professional, or they don't know how to be balanced. And so you have people who's, and it's like a Royal Rumble out here, and this is like in the black sector of YouTube. So it's like a Royal Rumble, like, okay, now let's turn against these other people who's pointing out this stuff. Now let's dig up stuff in your past. And I mean, you got this one, you see it on my channel, there's one young man, he's talked about Lenon Honor and saying accusations. Well, he wanna ask for donations because, you know, what 40-something year old man will ask for donations. And the whole point about, everybody asks for donations on YouTube. And people contribute, whatever their product is, they contribute. And whether they work part-time or whether they do full-time YouTube, but it's funny how somebody would criticize somebody, and at the same time, they have a cash app and say, well, you want to donate, but yet you criticize another people to be donate, which is kind of hypocritical of somebody. The reason he's criticizing Lenon, and people choose to donate Lenon because Lenon Honor was straightforward with what he does and let people know about the movie and show the day. He always record everything that he do. He records, so whatever your donations go to, he shows what he does with the people's donations. He showed that his son was sick in the hospital and stuff like that. And people saw it, not to use merciful tactics and guilt tactics. He had the evidence to show that he did. So this young man, you know, for some reason he got his bug up his butt, basically recording because, I don't know, you know, what, I don't come to the conclusion, well, he's not like my father, who's about the same age as he is, and why does he have, how come he don't get his credit card straightened out? And I mean, he's going all deep in thick business. And my view, I said, dude, you know, you're 20-something years old. Most of us who are up in our 40s and 50s know that maybe sometimes we start out
with good credit and good things are going on, but things happen. Like you get sick, you get divorced, you go through, you lose a job. There's people I know that that's been at their job for 20, 30 years, and all of a sudden the company comes by and they just take your job away. Now you're trying to, then you can't get an ample amount of time to pick up another trade when you're 50, then you're 60 years old, and you're trying to go back to school. But damn time you go back to school, you know, they you compete with somebody younger that they think is fresh and they can start it as new. So you got age discrimination in some cases with some companies is faced against you. So you didn't consider that in a change of life. You the same thing, you was, you're 25, we get to 45, 50, you didn't have about major things that happen. Your body didn't change. You might have children. They get older, and then things happen. You get sick in your body. Anything can happen. Job, let's see, and you act like things ain't gonna happen. And it's a lot of millennials and younger think that that's not gonna happen. Then you know, well, I'm gonna be set when I, well, it's easy saying that because we don't know what the next 20, 30 years is gonna be like. Because most of us in our 40s and 50s know we didn't match it up the way to now. When we look back there in the late 80s and 90s and stuff, we didn't know what the year 2020, 2021 gonna be like. And a lot of us didn't plan the route that you take. Some people have got sick, some people have gotten job, you know, had to change jobs three or four times. Some people went through a divorce. Some people go through things. And then there's people that I know out there that you see working two or three jobs, they try to keep a roof over their head. And it's still not enough. Because maybe where they're staying at is too high, so you have to change moving locations because adjustable of your income. So there's many, many reasons why things, but to sit up there and suggest that this man, and if people choose to help and they see that you're struggling, they relate to this man because they understand as a family man what he tried to do. But this young man that just got this buck up his butt behind it, and he's making videos. I mean, it's crazy, man, about it. And it's like, wow. I mean, it's one thing is to have your opinion about somebody, but and you tied to your opinion, but you don't intend. But if someone's pointing something obviously out about this individual, who is Umar Johnson, who says one thing and then act like he's a tyrant when it comes to telling people what they should do, what they can't do. Let me counsel you on couples, and then he's not married himself. He wants a wife, but he wants to counsel you on your relationship. And he talked about he wants two wives, and he's putting all his personal business out there. So people who's picking up his opportunity, analyze the video, make their own assumption, make their own opinion about it, and they can do what they want. Well, why you keep talking about this person? Ain't going, because it's like they see how hypocrisy and how ignorant this person is. It's like you really gonna send your kid to someone who act like that, who have that kind of influence on them? I mean, you know, that one minute they yelling out in the graveyard, talk about the ancient ancestors and give you maybe some mixing, sounding like he's trying to be legit, telling you about something about history, but it might be some things that's true about history, but his actions show that he's going to a gravesite and he's burning incense. I mean, this is what Lenon Honor and these other people point out. Like, something wrong with this man. People say you screaming, hollering, holding a cell phone like this, and constantly got to be on the cell phone. I mean, all the time. I mean, yelling in the phone. So people think, like, wow, what? Don't this guy got a job, do something on the side, and he's probably insist on people giving him money every day for his building that the taxes need paid on. And then they suggest a couple of things, that, and there were people that was on either side of these two, the anti-fraud warriors. There was people on either side that they just said, well, then here come the rational people. Why don't he go and get some private donors? Then he go, turn around, he sees famous people, he start calling them out their names, black individuals. You know, calling them the coons and saying things like that, racial epithet onto another black person, because they know, because what they do and what they associate with, and don't know anything about these people. So he telling his followers is this, but at the same time he wants to get poor people with the crazy check. That's what he called people who receive disability for themselves or their child, call it the crazy check. He says stuff like this. So he don't have too much respect for people. And you know, and then this is what he was pointing out in the video. He called them the black, you know, 10% of little black boys, they gonna be in the hood. You can't save all of them. He caught him on a lecture saying that. And he's showing that he's saying one thing, but he's not displaying what he's saying. And then he don't know, he's spilling so much. And here's the funny part about it. He's saying so much, knowing that it going to a social media, people see your name, put on a YouTube or Facebook, he said, let me see what this guy got to say. What the heck? So they go back to their channel and show all the outrageous, outlandish things that he said. So they make a whole video analyzing his behavior as a so-called professional. And then people going to get mad and try to justify his behavior. It's like, dude, if you want to go be around someone that think that's funny and entertaining, but just because you have a simple difference of opinion and agree, he going to call you out your name. Because worse than what a racist white person or other person will call you out your name. And this is the funny part about some black people. they call themselves their name, but if someone of another race called them the same name, you ready to knock their teeth down their throat. But why do you do that to another black person? I'm just saying, it don't add up. You know, you should know what that's like. But that's what people do. And so you take advantage of it. So that's why you see some videos I mentioned about him in the past, and called the anti-fraud warriors, and now you have other people in this particular sector of the black community. Black YouTube, you know, talk about, well, it's hilarious. And it's like, you know, is that woman, it's, you know, you have some people going like, yeah, this is kind of messed up. Then after a while, you mean, yeah, but why are you making money off, why you keep making video off of it? And why are you asking for donations? It's like, well, just like the other people, you know, it's a marketing. He's trying to market his own way. But it's not the way, we don't have the problem, people don't have the problem the way you market, it's the way you go about doing it. It sounds insane. First you use guilt shame tactics, and some people, you know, they have a product and say, if you like to donate, you can. They don't go and say, and it's a big difference if you would like to donate, ask people, can you donate to my channel, and say, see, or when you want to pretend, you see, this is what's wrong with you. We don't ever want to support your black people. This is what you do. And you're lazy, you're trifling. Because you don't, I'm trying to build a so-called future for our kids. So it's like, and then when some people do contribute, he made one video say it's not enough. And I mean, just, and someone's showing how ungrateful he is. I mean, it's crazy. So, you know, this is the hilarious thing down. Then he takes a topic for the day
And I said, you're looking at this man. He's like, wow. And so he's trying to open this trap. They call it a trap bandle school. The building is probably inside, look like it do a lot of work. Plus, you know, people are not really sending their kids to school right now because of the COVID, and it's across the country. There's a lot of people still, school districts are still having to do in schooling. And no matter what school you have, whether it's a charter school or private school or school, they're not really, they have it in class. And so, and they have to go by a protocol how to protect the kids and protect the staff. So a lot of people ain't really, you know, really too enthused about going back to going to a building right now and being around other people. Because, and then the building, this man got this building in, it's old. So it might be asbestos in there, it could be mold, it could be some other deterrents in there. And so they got tests for that. And then, you know, you want, you know, especially the drinking water, you know, because kids drinking water and different stuff like that. But, and then somebody suggested there's a whole process of keeping the school running. He didn't, but he said he has such a big ego, he don't want to listen to it. And then there was a couple people that said, hey man, it's, you know, this can fall. And then you have people that's turning around, they say, see, that's why if you would just let the man do what he do, and stop criticizing, that's what's wrong with black people. No, it's not that black people don't want to come together, but you want to know if someone's going to come together with somebody, they just going to use some common sense. And they're going to use some bully tactic and intimidation tactic just to get their point across. And what contact is, like, you know, our ancestors, well, yeah, that was back then, and using our ancestors, well, that was our ancestors right now, but we got to do it right now. And that's and some people don't care about all that, because there's people that deal with stuff now. History do count to a certain thing. So I said, okay, so you're fine about these people, what you going to do as your part? It's the same thing. I look at it this way. It's the same thing as the minister, a person who's teaching the pastor in the church. You don't mind giving a lesson and telling people what you should do. You know, you need to give your time and offerings, and you don't do this, and you need to do that. But at the same time, soon the Bible is closed, and you got some people who's a minister, or so-called pastor, or leader, but they don't fit the criteria of that book. They don't practice what they preach. And plus, they don't display the personality of, let's say, who they're studying about, to be the ambassadorship of Yeshua, Jesus. So basically, how can you tell me something, and when you honor the headship, it's the same principle of this headship of Christ, which you're supposed to be a spokesman of Christ, who we physically can't see, and what you represent. So in the same sense, if you represent something and you're professional, like you say who you are, your personality need to match up with who you are. It's not just words of mouth. See, a professional carry themselves a certain type of way in a profession. They don't go around just because any balance in how they talk to people. Even people, they have to go back to their own community. But you just can't act like you some Negro off the street, because even your own people won't take you seriously. And they're not impressed with, and there's some black people, yeah, they know about history, and some black people don't care, you know. They lived in the now. And black people, some black people like them, they live in the now. Some really don't care about history. They really don't. There's some that do and some that don't. Because in the ones that you're trying to convince the one to do, they look what, have a better understanding of yourself, and who they are, where they come from. and how they could be their own individual in light and make, be their own trendsetter in their own creation. And some have. But the problem is everybody trying to find that so-called black leader, that black messiah. It's not going to happen. Because you got too many in it among a group of people, even though we're the lowest totem pole as far as nationality, as far as stereotypes and things like that in this country and probably else in a few other countries. As far as, you know, with entertainment, that's all basically what it is. You know, you can rap song, you can send a trend, say something and say, come on, throw a couple, come on, let's see how you guys dance. Here, put a football and a basketball in his hands. Let's see how, ooh. And that's how they see you. And I mean, and that's how some people see it. And they talk to America and talk to the world. That's what black people are. If you're a black person, you know that there's more to it. They don't see it that way. They don't. So that's the reality. The reality of it is that they don't see it. People don't see them. So getting back to the situation with between these two men. So the one is breaking down and analyzing. This guy, he's saying that he's a psychiatrist, a psychologist, and family this. He don't fit the criteria. His demeanorism don't fit that. He don't present himself on video. And then he's on video all the time, even on his personal time. And it doesn't sound, and it sounded like in the beginning he sounded like he had his stuff together, but he was pointing out that, look, he sounded kind of off the wall. So that's why he was making all these videos about him. And he made this short documentary about him and showing what the history of what he said and what his actions does. Why he had to do a video? Why did he talk about it? Because he's showing other people, say, this is the kind of man you want to teach your kids. So he gonna, and that's the part where people gonna gravitate to the video and want to keep seeing it. Some people, they get tired, and some people do, but some people saying that understand his version, his view, why does he fit, and some people agree with it, some people don't agree with it. But with Umar Johnson, clearly is, you know, he has a narcissistic mentality. And it's, they just feel like he should guilt shame people. And guilt shame people when you don't care about the kids. People care about their kids. People love their kids. But they gotta watch it. But before you put your kids in someone's presence, and for 6 to 8 hours, you want to see what kind of person that they are. They can talk on flattery, but what the action show. Because you know that person can shape and mold their mind. And then as a parent, they, you know, people have to be wise about that. But when you sitting up there and screaming, hollering at, and they see you acting, doing crazy stuff at the cemetery, saying irrational things about you want a companion as a woman, saying irrational things about kids, that kind of raises up a couple red flags. So people see the video and show other people who are subscribed to them how incompetent this man is. Look at his personality. And I'm just saying, and I'm not subscribed to any of these channels, but I see when I'm like many people that watch through the YouTube feed and see what's really going on. And then they turn on one another. It's like, and I call it the Royal Rumble. It's like they turn on, like, it's a bad guy. Everybody was a good guy. Then all of a sudden, someone got to be a jerk. And let's go on the side of the jerk. Now, we're doing too much to this jerk. So they turn out to be the jerk. So you got people going back and forth in this particular black sector of YouTube. I mean, it's really, it's hilarious.
among mostly, which is mostly African Americans. That's what I meant to say, to those who are non-African Americans. But and so this is the big thing. So they make a video, and so it go, that's what, and it's breaking up analogy. And then you have some black people that they don't want you talk about your dysfunction with the world, but yet some of us do dysfunction in the world against each other, and then you still put it on the platform, and it becomes entertainment to some people. We have come dropping that YouTube feed and watch it, and it's entertaining. Some other people look like us, and then other people that come into it, it's like, you know, these personalities go back and forth and back and forth, and it's hilarious. I mean, it could be very, it's crazy at times. But anyway, you know, but they were just making valid points that something wrong with this guy, man. And so, this one guy, here's another guy I'm going to show you right quick that makes, you know, he makes his opposition. He's a pretty much middle guy. This guy's, his name is Max. I'm just going to show you, hope you don't mind. He makes it. And they get on him. He's pretty much a guy that's just pretty much middle. Those people come a little emotional. A famous speech that they got into the live chat. They struck his candle. He's a pretty cool dude. So he took his channel down. They struck his channel. Free so-called freedom of speech. I think it's going to eventually, there's going to be other platforms, people are going to be leaving YouTube. Because, I mean, you know, it was something that's, it wasn't, you know, people cuss and fuss and,
away so much limited freedom. Even when something is not offensive to somebody, there's a particular religion, a particular sort, sexual orientation, or something like that, or something. Then the government, YouTube has just gone off the walls. I mean, and I can see if it was something like on a level like, if it's like, you know, something like, you know, showing children or pornographic or something like that. Yeah, I understand you get a strike for that. I can also understand you say something politically about someone's religion. I mean, it sound like, you know, if it would incite to jump on someone's religious belief or someone's sexual orientation or handicap. But come on, man. I mean, geez, just because someone has a, people get on a group of people that talk about another individual, it's getting petty. And I think that eventually, probably sometime this year, the next couple of years, people gonna leave YouTube because they just got too overboard with this stuff. Way too overboard with their analogy. Trying to control someone's speech and watch what they saying. You can't say that. You can't say that. It's a bunch of grown people up there all night. And then they put a slogan that this is not for children. So if there's no children watching adults having adult conversation. What is the big deal? I think it's crazy because there's certain things you're allowed to do, and you're allowed to disagree with another adult doing something. You shouldn't have to be worried about that. And if some people get emotional, get a little bit of cussing, they're gonna cuss. Some people are like that. I mean, as long as they don't say something that threaten somebody, threaten violence against a group of people, again, what I said earlier, why you had to strike and take the channel down? I don't understand that. I mean, that's my feeling on that. But it's like, wow. That's why people come in to make friends and to find bonds with across the country. And then you have someone come to control you, which is supposed to be a liberal outlet of how you feel. Is that, for example, if somebody, you know, say something about black people and they're of another race, I'm not going to go to their channel. Why would I need to go to their channel if they're racist or biased or something like that? They can say anything they want. That's their freedom of speech. I don't agree with it, but it's just that I think that, you know, you can't say nothing. So people are going to start leaving the platform for after a while and go to other social outlets. So that's something that YouTube won't take notice. It's going to probably be in the future like how Snapchat, what was that? Was that Snapchat or the one social view? Because it's like people getting tired of that, man. And people have formed bonds and connections with people. And they share things in common. It's like I said, if it ain't hurt nobody, what is the big deal? But it, you know, I record it because it's, you know, I'm showing an example. But I mean, I'm not asking someone to jump on somebody or anything like that. But it's like, God, man, you can't even say nothing. That is not long as now you're about to decide a riot. What the heck? You know, people should be able to share another strike in your channel because I mean, like I said, unless it's the five things. Number one, if your channel gets strike, if it's showing pornographic or something like that, yeah. If you're picking on someone because of sexual orientation and threatening to harm them and violent them, yeah, I can understand your channel getting striked down for that. If your channel is promoting to jump on someone's religious organization or something like that, or promote harm and violence, and or promote trying to blow up the government, yeah, you get strikes for that because you intentionally. But geez, just because someone, if you don't like what someone do, whether it's a company, and then the latest thing is, you know, that's someone's opinion what they feel about the vaccines. I think that's opinion. No, that's conspiracy theory. So they take it to, so they strike you for that. It's like, where's the freedom of speech? Dang, if I'm not doing the five things, threatening against the government, threatening the individual because of their religion, threatening because of sexual orientation, or the color, or the, what is with the strikes? I don't get that. I don't get it. For these people that's monitoring, I don't get it. Some allowed to have their own opinion. Anyways, and then there's some actual evidence that educational, and it may seem kind of offensive to a group of people, but if it's educational, and it's real and it's facts, what's the big deal? You know, people choose to look at it and choose not to look at it. Again, if someone, that's their opinion. People, if they go out and get facts and they put it on a channel, that's their opinion. But then it's almost, I believe we moving to a socialistic time. Now you can't say anything. If you say something, they're gonna persecute you. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, you guys have a good night. But that was what I was saying earlier about that situation was going on this sector. I'm going to probably make a commentary, redo a commentary of what I thought about these riots. I'm going to do another one. All right, you guys take care.
We haven't seen any major issues. They were expecting things to be relatively calm.